Welcome back to PJ Chen Design. And YouTube subscriber Nari wrote me an email asking if I can show you guys this type of a form. So I decided to talk about those four different forms here. They are done by simply only use the twist command, and also some of them have polar array. Are you ready? Let's get started. Let's start the first one with the star. We are going to the polygon tool and you have polygon star. Let's hit enter. And then we want to have something simple. So let's set the number of a side to 5. And we will come up something like this. And moving in, then how you get the star. To make our form look more smoother, we can go in for the fillet corners. And we want gonna pick up the curve, we want to fit it and type it the radius, I think 1.5 is fine. So now we have that first one. All we need to do is make it into the solid. So let's stay with the perspective view. Let's click on the curve and we go into the solid extruded planar curve. Let's go up about 10. Let's use the twist command. Let's go to the twist and we select the object. We hit 0 as our first point for the rotating axis. And we're gonna go up anywhere above the object. Then we're going to the top view, click on anywhere, and you can rotate it into any degree that you want. I'm here just rotating 90 degrees. So this is the shape that we get. So let's go ahead to set up the bottom one for curve. There are two ways you can make it. First of all, again, you can use the star. And this time we need to have more polygons. So let's use 12 and coming back in like this. Now this is our top view. We also want to make sure it is rounded all the way. So we're going to use exactly the same command. Go into the curve tool, you have fillet corner. Let's pick up one. A lot of time you're gonna end up with one, it is not fillet. You just need to go back and use the same radius one to do the fillet. All right, so we're gonna do the comparison. Let's put this one on the side to compare the curve. The second curve, what I'm going to do is instead of using the polygon like what we have here, we're going to use the curve tool and I'm going to turn on the grid snap, approximately snapping about right there. Okay, then I'm going to use the command is polar array. That's array with the center and we're gonna do the same number for 12. So that's how you get this. After you get this, then you can trim it anything inside. So I'm gonna trim it all of those. And then join them together. Then I'm going to use the same command we used before, fillet corner. And this time we wanna do the fillet 4.5. So that's how you get this. Notice that those two forms is really similar. It's just like one of it is the same radius on all the corners. This one is you keep the original round shape and by adding the smaller radius here. Okay, both of them will work. I'm going to use the second one over there. Using the curve tool, snapping into the quadrant here and coming up to my front view. From the front view, I'm going to create an arc. And this arc will be our shape over there. You can turn on a grid snap and then you can snap it into the grid. And you can change in the curve to find what is the best for you. I do want it to have some sort of like puffy looking form. All right, so now I get this one here. To creating this surface, we're going to use the command is under the surface, and then you have the rail revolve. This is going to be our profile, and this is going to be our rail. And we're going to starting from here and ending that's going down here. And then we will get this surface right there. Now we have the surface. The only thing we need to do is to twist it. So let's go ahead to select the object. And we want snapping into the endpoint coming down here. And we go back to the top view to twist about 90 degrees. All right, so that's how we get the second form look like, or the decoration on the cake. Now let's take a look on the third form. The third one is most likely a bunch of a rope together. So you're kind of guessing if you can make one, and then you can polarize and you can make a bunch of them. So let's talk about how do we make that one. We're going to go to the top view, and we're going to create a sphere first. So let's go ahead to create a sphere like this way. Okay, and then I would like to look at all four view. Let's go to the curve tool, and we have this is called spiral, and I want a flat spiral. So let's pick a center, and it will be 0 point, or you can click it at the endpoint. Then I'm going to snapping into the quadrant and coming back for a turn. Now you can change in, like if you feel like 1.5 is not enough, you can change to 2 or 3 or whichever work for you. You might need to try and see which one worked the best. Okay, now we have something like this. We need to have that curve projected to the surface that we have. Okay, and then since we only need the top, we don't need the bottom, I'm going to split with the point right at this quadrant. All right, so we're gonna delete the rest of it. And also we're gonna hide it the original curve. Now that's piping this guy. I'm going to pipe it with the diameter 4.5. And that's how I get this shape. The rest is the polar array. So we're gonna do the polar array. We're gonna make it a little bit more than what we want to get that density. So let me try 25 and see what this turned out. So it turned out to be like this. It might be a little bit dense, but you get what I mean here. Okay, the very last one that we wanted to talk about is this wire construction here. This wire construction is really similar way that we worked before. As you can see, there must be piping something going on. The only difference between this one and this one is this one will pipe first and polar array. This one probably done polar array or something. The foam is already done and we twist it. Okay, so let's take a look how I get this more like a cage looking shape. Again, we will need a sphere first, so we're gonna go ahead to create a sphere, a roughly similar size like what we had. And I'm going to, since we're gonna have a half of them, so I'm gonna draw a line right there. And use that line to trim the bottom half. Now I trim it, let's take a look on this shape. All right, so if we try to turn on the control point, there are not much to turn on over there. So what I'm going to do is to rebuild this one. And we want to rebuild into a lot more point. And you kind of see that this is some ghost things underneath there. That's okay. It's because the Rhino will remember the shape with the history for what was it. Then let's go ahead to change to 2012, and then we click OK. So now we have this form here. What we wanted to do is we're gonna use the curve tool, and then you have curve from the object, and then you have this wireframe. That means all the lines that you see as an iso curve, it's going to turn into a curve. I'm going to select all the curve. and we are going to use the pipe tool, and let's make it a little bit smaller, so 0.25, and that's how we get the shape here. Let's use the twist command. Let's pick up the object, enter, and the starting twist, I'm going to hit 0, and moving my mouse above the object, and then I want to do 90 degree twist. So that is how we get this form. Let me know if you have other form that is interesting that you would like to see. A lot of time I cannot make exactly the same due to jury has a copyright, but it is an educational channel. I would like to show you whether something close or discuss the surface and how to make it. Hopefully that will help you a lot on your Rhino modeling skill. Leave the comment below, let me know what you think, or if you have other questions. I'll see you next.